We will again we will do that, and g value we will get that. Y start and y end will be equal for a y axis and x axis. So only the image will be at this corner, it will be get set there. Able to understand that at this corner we will set that. At this corner y end will be, this will be equal x start. How can I say, means now we will get that. Using this we will get the gradient. Noisy value is added from the tiles. Exactly what now happened I will explain that. From the image size, from the image size we make into the tiles. Okay, we are making into the lot of tiles. Okay, there will be number of tiles is present, and every tiles we divided by 1/4. For every 1/4, based on the image, like a image, we are adding the some noisy value over here. Over everything the noisy value is added. The gradient is going to be happen over, the gradient formula is applied. So every, it is, this both things are equal. We are finding this both things are equal. Y start, y end, x start, x end. It is both the things are equal. This both the things are equal. It is finding that if it is equal, means the image will be similar like CV2. The image will be equal. So this is an IC value is added. So every gradient in the optimization, able to understand that, right? For every optimization of image, okay, the image will be, you can able to understand this, right? Hello, any doubt?
A little bit complicated, but it is understandable, right?
Hello.
Yes, Vimal.
Okay.
I mean, not completely, but yes, little bit understandable.
Here is also gradient only helping the noisy value to adapt to the image size. The gradient is optimizing here. And after that, I'm just going to take that noisy value and patch into the my image. And after that, I'm resizing, and the dream is applying, and I'm upscaling again, and dream is applying, and upscaling, the dream is applying. It will be fixed into the image. Okay, able to understand? The downscaling and upscaling will be happen for every deep dream is applied. Now here only, okay. First thing is optimizer, we will use that optimizer. First thing is we will take the image.copy. What the image we are having, original image, we need to overwrite that. Okay, image before and after the image. Okay, image before and after the image, we are going to do that. Okay, first thing is model dot get underscore gradient layer underscore tensor. Okay, the tensor layer we are going to obtain here. Tiled underscore gradient, we are going to apply the tiled underscore gradient. Okay, over here for every iteration the gradient will be applied, and the image will be also applied. The gradient will be also applied. Image before and a processed image we will get. The optimization where we have used, if I show that, means you can understand. Image before, and this will be every iteration the gradient min max we will get that noisy value. This is going to be that gradient tiles. The gradient tiles, it will be very lessing to the point. The processed image.
Sorry. Oh my God. Sorry, actually I fell my phone down. Okay, now able to understand, right? Now the tiled gradient, image before, okay, the image dot copy. This is a tiled gradient for a every image. For every image iteration, the Gaussian filter also applied. The Gaussian filter will, what it will be do means it will be applied over every time, means it will be smooth the graph. It will be smooth the graph from the data, the image and tiled gradient. Image, the tiled gradient, it will be optimized. Here the optimization will be happen, and every show gradient will be shown over here. The min max, the gradient will be shown over here. Able to understand, right? This is exactly the Gaussian filter will be applying. The image on the tile gradient, this is only repeating the number of iteration. The number of iteration, defaultly 10. Able to understand, right? This is an optimized image. This is a tiled gradient, and a Gaussian filter is applied. This is a little bit understandable, but if you overview the lot of problems, means you can understand. The neural trial style transfer also similar like this only. Neural style transfer means it will be mixing the two images. Here we are applying only the noisy value on side, and we will make into like a shape like that, and after that we are patching that. Okay, but if in the style transfer, what we will do means we will make a gradient of the one image, and we will make into apply into the another image. The gradient also update there also. Actually, here the gradient, why we are using the gradient means we will use it for optimization of the loss. We will use a gradient. Okay, in machine learning, in neural network, we will use the for optimization thing, we will use the gradient, right? They are playing with the gradient. Okay, able to understand, right? They are using the gradient as a noisy value, and after that they are patching. The get gradient, we will apply the layered tensor. The layered tensor, we will get that gradient. Actually, where we are exactly doing this thing means in inception H5 model. Okay, inception H5 model, we are exactly do this thing. Actually, why we are learning the deep dream neural trace transfer means you will get the new ideas. Okay, you can generate new things. Okay, like deep dream are just a paper. Okay, but it is not used as application, but it's just a paper from generative adversarial network. While someone reading the generative adversarial network, they got ideas related, like we can make like this thing, deep dream. We can make the neural style transfer. From generative adversarial network, they get some ideas and make this thing. If you have an idea like making from a generative adversarial network, you can generate a new things. Okay, you can like a wall designing. Okay. Wall designing, what kind of things you can make a wall designing, different wall designing you can make using the, you can take the images and you can make like a Picasso, you can make an image, you can make an image like that. Able to understand, right? You can make the image. You will also get the idea, any idea, like if you have any from the neural network, you have learned the neural network, you have learned, you know, basic concept of the GAN. So you also get some ideas to generate the new things. And actually, before that,
NLP is used. Nowadays they are using Berkan. You know, Google is changed the new thing. This year only they have changed the new thing. Okay, similar like that, you can get the new ideas. Okay, the tile gradient is applied. The tile gradient is applied. After that, Gaussian filter is, we will use that, and we will add the three smoothers also. And after that, if adding the three smooth, we will use them for every step size. We are going to apply the gradient. This is a gradient formula. I have told that, right? For everything, we will do the same. For every step size, we will do that. And we will plot the gradient, plot underscore gradient. That is exactly the plot gradient is working, the helper function. Plot gradient is working now. Now the normalization is working here. The plot gradient is working, and every step format we are doing that. After that, we are doing the optimization. Optimization, we are passing the layered tensor. The layered tensor is nothing but this one, the model dot layer underscore tensor. We are taking the one layer, one empty layer, con2D layer. We are taking that layer and we are passing the layer tensor from the model. Okay, after that we will do the iteration. It will be bring up like this. Able to understand? Hello? Now optimization, how it's exactly working, you can understand, right? Like we are directly doing the tile gradient and gradient, plot gradient, we are doing that. For every plot gradient, the noisy value is added over there. So based on that image, the gradient will be get, we will get the gradient. Able to understand, right? Hello? You can able to analyze, right? Gaussian filter will be here, every step the gradient is applied. Because of the gradient, it will be optimized. The noisy value get optimized like the image we have. Because of gradient only, the image get, the noisy value also get optimized to that optimized. Able to understand, right? Hello. You can able to understand, or it's difficult for every update of image. It is also emitted from the image. The gradient doing that. The gradient doing the, it will be last the error in neural network, okay? In neural network, it will be last the error. Similar like that, it will be try to last the, it will be emitted like a image, like that image into this image while doing the optimization. It will be continuously doing the tile gradient and gradient. It will be do the, from the model, it will be continuously doing that, and we will get that. The Gaussian filter will be applied over everything, and we will get that image. Able to understand this? Hello? After the optimization, able to understand? Due to the tile gradient only, it will be happening. Hello? Hello?
Yes, Vimal.
Okay. Able to understand now? It's a little bit confusing, right? Hello? Okay. Next, we will see the recursive optimizer. But before we will 5 minutes break, you have any doubt, you can ask now. Okay. You have any doubt? Hello? Hello, you have any doubt? Or it's very complicated. If you view over this problem means, if you started to view over the like a problem like this means, after that, the small problems are very small one. If you started to solve the problem like this, the bigger problem means deep dream neural transfer, this thing or you are try to solve that means, the neural network are a very small one. When compared to this, first thing is I have shown the Keras, okay? The Keras is a little bit difficult, okay? A little bit difficult, and after that, it is very easier only. After that, I have shown the TensorFlow. TensorFlow is also little bit difficult when compared to Keras, but when compared to TensorFlow, after that I have shown the algorithm and the TensorFlow is also somewhat understandable. It is, but next I am showing the Deep Dream. This is when compared to TensorFlow, this is somewhat deep, right? Hello. Right.
Yes.
So it will be like, while going the deep, it will be understandable. Exactly. While you are going to like a deep, again, this deep dream is basic one, but neural trail transfer, that is very complicated. That is also somewhat, and after that, if you go like a lot of difficult problem means you can do any lot of problems you can able to solve. If I giving any code means just to change the image, just to do the training, and you can also get the output. But after that, just understand the code and you can make the code like what exactly the deep dream is working and how can we make that. Okay. Once you understand the concept means you can make, okay. Once you have to understand the concept, like next thing for this thing, next thing I have to do this thing, for this thing I have to do the thing. You have to start to understand. While the flow of code itself, you can understand. If 2 to 3 time it's showing the error means, you can understand that after that, this thing, you have to do this thing, and you will understand. Okay. Actually, a lot of them will say that Java is very difficult when compared to Python. But while seeing the deep dream, this thing, neural trace transfer, while using the neural network and using the machine learning in deep concept, okay, inception model, the transfer learning, it will be very, very, very much at the stage of complication. Complicated things will be there. Okay, there is a 12:55. Okay, we will start at 1 o'clock, okay? Hello? Is it okay? Five minutes, we will take the break, okay? Is it okay?
Yes, okay.
That, we will see the recursive optimization. Okay.
Okay.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now we will start the. Okay. Okay. Next thing is we will see about the recursive. Actually, the recursive means this will be the recursive means the changes over the changes. Okay, the recurrent neural network, they are saying, right? Recurrent means the changes in one layer and next layer will be changes. There will be continuous changes. If a continuous changes the over the image, the optimization occur means what will happen. Okay, we will see that. First thing is number of repeats that will be 4. Okay, for a 4 iteration it's going to do. For a 4 iteration we are going to do. Okay, it will be like image blur. First thing is we are going to use a Gaussian filter. Image going to be filled blur. The Gaussian filter is mostly used for blurring the image. Image going to be blur. Okay, what are the image going to be are passing that going to be blur, and the blur image going to be downscaled. Okay, downscaling will happen. And the next thing is recursive optimization. This is again going to be done. Okay, for every step -1, for every -1 step, that is a 4, 3, 2, 1. For everything it will be happen. The blur and downscale, blur, downscale. Again, it will be going to that and down scale. And the while upscaling, okay, we are resizing the image. Okay, based on the image result, we are resizing the image and to the normal image, original image, back to the original image. While we are doing that, we are going to process over here. That blend. The blend means we are while upscaling, okay, we will blend the original image. While resizing to the original image, we are applying the optimization image. While upscaling, we will optimize the image. While resizing, we will optimize the image. Able to understand, right? This is exactly the recursive optimization. First thing is, we will blur the image. We will resize to the down. After the 4th step, it will be resized. While upsizing, we will pass into the optimization image. This is exactly happening in the recursive neural network. Recursive optimization. So only it will be like a chain. So it will be recursive optimization. The blend means, you suppose exactly blend what happening here. I will explain that. The upscaling is happened. Okay, for a 1.0 here, image upscaled into, if a blend is 0.9 means 0.9 into image means it will be upscaling. It will be upscaled to that point. Similar like that for every blend, it will be upscaled. For 0.2, it will be upscaled. For every upscale, the optimization image will be passed over there. So only the optimization image is passed over there. For that process is happened means, for a recursive thing, so only the deep dream will happen. First thing is the image before the image. Okay, image after processing, there will be blur. There is a blur. You can able to see from this image, there is a Gaussian filter is applied, so here some blur things is there, and after that image before, after that the blur with the optimization is applied. Image before and blurring and optimization is happened. Similar like that, if we do means we will get that. Blurring, blur the things. First thing is blur. After that, recursive, it will be do. Able to understand the image before. This is the Gaussian filter. The recursive level you can see. Recursive level, I think it is printed. Recursive level 3, 2, 1. Image before, actually image before, image after is printed over, that is made over here. Image filter, image before, the processed image, image after, this is happen over the optimization. Actually in the optimization it is happening, image before, image after. Able to understand, right? The blurred image, first blurred image will be passed inside. First thing is we are blurred the image, the passing the image into this, and we will get the image result. And the next thing is we will get that same image and we will blur that and we will pass in this and we will pass in this, and again we will do that, again we will do that, and we will get that optimization. Able to understand, right? Hello.
Yes, Vimal. So I have a question, like deep dream is used in inception and recursive image optimization, right? I mean, in both we can use deep dream.
Yeah, using the inception model, we will use that. What you ask? Once again, you can ask again.
So, I mean, how we will identify, like, where we have to use inception and where we have to use recursive image optimization?
Actually, the recursive is a original thing. Recursive is the original thing, okay? The recursive is the original thing. Optimization is for showing the noisy thing. Noisy value is used. For showing the noisy value is used. So we will use optimization image. Able to understand? This is used for showing the noisy values get changed according to the image. This is a deep dream. You can able to see that. For this is the optimization, and this is used inside that. Recursive is a real output we have to get. Recursive is a real output we have to get. And optimization image, we are just seeing that if we adding the noisy value means what will be happen. We are seeing that the noisy value is added and the process is happened. Here optimization image, the noisy value is added and the optimization happens. Here is also.
Okay.
Here we are getting the output based on the blurred things. We will get the output continuously. The blurred things and upscaling and downscaling, we will get the deep dream.
Okay, so both are following the same process, like the inception and the recursive image optimization.
Yeah, both are based on the inception. Inception model is actually we have taken. Able to understand this? Actually, this is a deep dream. Actually, the downscaling, upscaling, the optimization, the image, and we are continuously doing this. We will get the deep dream. There is a lot of deep dream images. Okay, once again. These are a lot of deep dream images. This image you can see, there is a lot of deep dream images. This is a normal image while applying the deep dream. This is a deep dream. These are the deep dream images. You able to understand? It will be changed like this only.
Yes.
These are the deep rings.
I mean, so image with some noise.
Yeah, adding with some noise and gradient is a gradient will do all the process. Gradient is a main thing here. Gradient will be downscale and upscale. First year we have seen that. Exactly, you can see there. The for every image, the gradient will be updated. Use the gradient to update the image. For every gradient, the image will be get updated. For every gradient, image will be updated. But there will be, we will less the loss. And for a prediction, we will less the loss. But here, the what we are doing means we are using for the image to update the gradient. For a gradient, we will be update. For every gradient update, this is the just to think this is optimization. Okay, this is the optimization. Okay, this is optimization. We have used the optimization function. This is optimization function. This is a recurrence function. Able to understand, right? This is a recurrent function. Recursive optimization function. This is a recursive optimization function. And this is a this is an optimization function. This is a recursive optimization function. Able to understand now? Hello? But we will use that function inside this. For every time you have to apply this deep dream is that optimization function. This deep dream is that optimization function. That upward optimization function. The deep dream is optimization function. Able to understand now?
Hello? Yes.
Okay. Next, we will see the neural style transfer. Okay, we will end up at 2 o'clock. Okay, on which time? We will end up at 2 o'clock. Okay. Actually, here, what it will be do means, here we will use the style loss and the content loss using a gradient to update the image. Here also, the gradient will be play important role, similar like that. And generative discriminative also gradient will do, gradient is also important thing. It will be optimized. I told that there will be optimization occur, but generative will be increase the value and discriminative will decrease the value. Okay, on the point it will be like the generative and the discriminative will be present. Okay, generative and discriminative will be present. Generative and discriminative will be present. Similar like that, here also we will do that. The style loss and the content loss will be happen and using gradient to update the image. First thing is, we will pass the two image into the layer. What will be do means, it will lose the style loss and content loss. It will do the style loss, content loss, and gradient will optimize, try to optimize like the style. This is the content, this is the style. Actually, the style loss will be decreased over here using the gradient. The content loss will be decreased over the third layer. The first layer, this loss will be get decreased. Okay. This loss will be get decreased. Okay. The style loss will be get 2 times decreased and the content loss will be at third layer, it will be get decreased. While merging this, use the gradient to update the image. Okay. While gradient will be help to merge the two things. You will see the lot of which time we will start class. Okay, we will end up at 2. Okay, we will end up at
1:30. We started at 10:30.
Okay, we will end up at 1:30 also. We will end up. Okay. You can able to okay. Understand, right?
Mm-hmm.
This thing. Able to understand a little bit, but while we are viewing a lot of things, you can understand. Okay, this is, you can also try this. You know, the important, I will watch mostly Siraj Rawal video. Siraj Rawal YouTube.
Yes,
he's very much expert actually. He will do the GAN. This thing he will do. Neural file transfer, Siraj Rawal video. This is the GAN. Using the GAN, we can make the like this, converting the RC into zebra. You can do that using the generative adversarial network. Actually, I have neural trial transfer. It will become all the topics. Auto encoder, recurrent neural network, and this is a generative adversarial network. I have said that lot of face will be created. If you type GAN here itself, generate a Pokemon with GAN, and this thing are this is a style transfer. This is a style transfer. This is a style transfer is used. Okay. Deep Dream also, he also uses the Deep Dream. He is also using the Deep Dream. He is also using the Deep Dream. Similar like that, we have tried that, right? Similar like that, we will use that. Here I will go through the, actually the time is, we have very less time. I will overview, and tomorrow we will see the neural style transfer, and we will try to, actually today in the entire classes Deep Dream is gone. Okay. I will overview. Okay, so you can understand about the basic. Okay, so tomorrow we will overview the thing. Okay. Here is also, we will add some, actually we will, while using the generative adversarial network, okay, the main thing you have to know that is np.0. okay, np.0, you know np.0, like, yes, that image. Okay, we have to take like that. Every time you are going to generate new things, means you have to add some noisy value. That is the main thing. And the next thing is, np.0 will be used. Here is also it will be used. One second, control F.
So why we are using np.0?
Like if suppose I'm using, that means I will take the zeros, okay, zero of all values. Okay, first before going to do the operation, I will take the image, like an image, I will take the zero of that all the value. Mm-hmm. I will add the noisy over there.
Mm-hmm.
Similar like that, we will take that. This is the np.0, like an image. This is the np.0 of image. Like this, both the image, the np.0.
Mm-hmm.
Well, before.
Okay, the middle one is np.0. And
yeah,
the both are the first and the third one is.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, style transfer we have used. The style transfer VGC16. VGC16 means that is, I have already told that for color prediction they will use the VGC16. So here we are using the VGC16 for color the both the things. For coloring the things, we are using the VGC16. This is also your actually. After the transfer learning, it will become, okay, the VGC16. Mm-hmm. We have used the inception model for deep dream. For a style transfer, we are using the VGC16. Similar like that, we are using the things. Here we have added the noisy value. We will overview and we will, this is a style loss. This is the content loss. This is the helper functions. First thing, VGC16, we have taken VGC16 model. I think in Keras also there is a VGC16, but we will pip install VGC16. Mm-hmm. We will take that model. This is a transfer learning, okay. We have taken the helper function. Some helper function we will take, save image, plot image. And plot images and mean square error, we have used the mean square error, and there is a content loss, style loss. In GitHub I have seen one guy did the three image style transfer, three images based on the three images the style is transferred in one image. We can do that also. Three image, taking a three image. The content layers, the style layer. The content loss, the style loss, we are going to do that. And we will some noisy value also added. In between added, right? That is a noisy value. In between added, that is a noisy value. This is exactly what it is means. This is exactly the in between noise. They have not used the np loss here, but we can use that also. np.0s also we can take, and we will. We here also we will make the tiles, taking the each tiles we will make like that also. And another way is they have used the here also the gradient will be applied from the image. You can, this is a blueprint, similar like blueprint what we are going to do. This is a blueprint. You can see that two content layer and the style layer, style, this is a content, this is a style. We will lost the style loss. Here we at last layer only we will going to do the content loss. We will do this continuously means after that the gradient will, what the gradient exactly doing this is it will optimize. Okay, here the image will be also get optimized. Okay, you know, actually we will use the gradient only for minimizing the loss, right? what kind of loss if it is occur means a linear regression means we will try to decrease the mean square loss. If it is a binary, if it is a any classification problem means we will use a binary class entropy. That is the NP dot softmax cross entropy we will use, or otherwise we will softmax cross entropy with underscore legits we will use, and we will, inside the legits we will take the x label, and the labels we will take the label targeted value, we will take that, and in a binary cross entropy. And we will, another thing we have used for that is minus np dot argmax of inside that value plus np dot log of that x value, we will use that. That is a binary cross entropy, we will use that. These are some of the formula for the last function we will use on the use optimizer, but they are using the gradient for inside the images itself. Okay, this is a direct passing, actually it is not predict anything, but you can take this model and you can use a different images also. Okay, we can use a different images also. Able to understand? Actually, another thing I have to say, like you can try with Kaggle also. Okay, this thing are in Kaggle also. If you try the Grandmaster, you know Grandmaster in Kaggle. Actually, the one Indian guy is now Grandmaster in Kaggle. Actually, there is a three Grandmaster in Kaggle. First one is discussion. Mm-hmm. Discussion means what kind of discussion they are making. They giving a useful point means that is a discussion grandmaster. And there is a three. There is a competition for a competition. There is a interstitial, I think, interstitial grandmaster, competitional grandmaster. Competition, if you take the three grandmaster means you are the like you will get any project in the world, machine learning project. Three grandmaster is there in Kaggle. You can try that also. There is a competition also. There is a lot of competition. You can try that also for predicting things. Okay. Able to understand this, right? We will actually here we will use a softmax classifier. Softmax, you know softmax. This will be activation function we will use in neural network.
Yes.
And we will overview the image captioning, natural language processing.
So we have covered NLP.
Yeah, we have to cover that also. We have to cover that also. I'm just moving from base to deep. Okay. After that, you understand this thing means, okay, mm-hmm. I will like overflow. I will try to teach everything. I will cover everything. I just trying to now understand from a deep to, you can now able to understand what is exactly how the mm-hmm. gradient will be working. Gradient, try to optimize the thing. You can understand now the concept. So after that, we will cover that every topic. We need to cover the Keras also. Keras also, still it is blank only. Keras now only we will start. Now only we are going to start, okay? The Keras TensorFlow, everything. Oh. But this is a concept, a basic concept you have to understand. So I'm just covering only the basic concept. So after that only we will cover that NLP, everything. You
able to understand? Sure. Yes.
Actually, the image captioning, what it is do means from the image, okay, it will tell the story. This is a convolution layer, but there is no output layer. It will be directly connected to the recurrent neural network, and it will tell the story, the big brown bear sitting. Okay, this is the embedding, the word embedding, that is a vectorized and a tokenized word. And based on the tokenized, we will get the output. This is a neural network. Big brown sitting and everything will be tokenized. And we will get the exact output. embedding based on the vectorization, we will get the output based on the pixel. Big brown sitting, bear sitting. Okay. This is the image captioning. This is the convolution neural network, but this is the recurrent neural network. We are combining both the things and we are doing the a big brown bear sitting. Able to understand this basic, just understand. If I am typing the same thing, big brown bear sitting. You can able to find, right? Big brown bear is sitting. Here you can able to see every image. Google also doing same thing only.
Okay.
This is the image captioning. Able to understand? CNN and RNN is working. What? Hello? Able to understand, right? These are the basic things. These are the application, like application wise, we can work with this neural network. You can make a new things. Actually, nowadays they are not working on this thing. Actually, this thing are in research, completely in research. Okay. We will end up the session. Is it okay? Any doubt? Hello.
No woman.
Okay, now it is understandable, right? Somewhat when compared to before, it is understandable, right?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, if you overview again and again, means it will be, you can do a lot of things also. I'm asking one question, you can answer or not. I will try to do that, okay? I will ask one question, Ruchi. There is an industry, okay?
Mm-hmm.
There is an industry. Some of them are wearing helmet, some of them are not wearing helmet. There is a live stream, okay? You have to build the model, okay? Those are not wearing helmet, and those are wearing helmet. You have to do that. What you will do in this time? What you will do?
So I mean, which model we will do? Yeah,
which model you will do? Wearing helmet.
So we have to identify like which
neural network
wearing and helmet or
and what are the data you will use and what are the data you will use and what are the input data you will use? What are the output data you will use?
So I think RNN we can use.
Actually, here what we will do means input. First thing is what we have to do means output image, output side will be two things. Output will be two thing. We have to use like Ola object detection. Output is 1, 2. That is wearing helmet or not wearing helmet. That is output layer will be 2.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The input layer will be every pixel or every live streaming. Okay, which will be passing inside. Okay, as a video format or frame will be passing. Mm-hmm. Every frame will be passing. The output will be the 2 output. Whether they wearing or not wearing. The live streaming will be passing every time. Okay, already you have to train the live stream that they are wearing helmet, not wearing helmet. You have to stream that and you have to train the model. After that you can able to predict. Able to understand? Hello?
Yes. That so is, which model we have to use, like
CNN we will use for an image.
Okay, convolution.
Yeah, convolution neural network. Recurrent neural network, what kind of problem you will use means, if suppose, one second. If suppose you are using the problem like if
for recurrent neural network where you can use means like a Google translator word, like you're using the word embedding. Yeah, you can use for like which language they are talking. You can use that also, recurrent neural network. Using the recurrent neural network, you can predict that, like which language they are speaking. This word is from this language. This word is from this language. You can able to predict that also. That is not nowadays they are, there is no like this. Actually, why they are not using the machine learning? Why they are not? Because of data only. They cannot able to collect the data. So only they need to collect a lot of data. They need to have the lot of data, like clean data. They should have the exact data. So only. Okay. Next thing is I can ask. If suppose okay. Yeah, I already they have asked this question to you. If there is a road is lot of damaged road, there is a not damaged road, okay. Using the drone, mm-hmm. okay. Using the drone, the mm-hmm. drone is built of Raspberry Pi. The Raspberry Pi is run under the Python, okay. So don't need to worry about the model mm-hmm. building. The Python will be run, okay. The Raspberry Pi is the drone is built mm-hmm. of Raspberry Pi, okay. Now we need to use OpenCV. Mm-hmm. OpenCV 2 we will predict. Which model we will use to predict whether the road is damaged or not? How much percentage of damage is there? How much percentage of damage is not there? Actually, how can we can do that?
So I think it is. I mean, using machine learning, we can also identify like.
Yeah, we can use a machine learning, and we can use a CNN also. Here we can use okay. a CNN. CNN also. We
so.
Will, If a business problem means we can use AI and an artificial neural network, we can predict. Okay, if suppose mm-hmm. a business if suppose a image or viewing something means we can use a CNN. But if suppose from the image we are generating some text, okay, if suppose the server is mm-hmm. down, getting down, okay, we need to get alert. Of the things means it will be create the text that the if suppose I will ask another question, okay, there is a pipeline mm-hmm. okay, there is a pipeline mm-hmm. gasoline pipeline, there is a lot of gasoline pipeline mm-hmm. We have used the machine learning, okay, we have using mm-hmm. the machine learning. If suppose the damage happen in any of the point, okay, gasoline, okay, it will be tell that at this point the damage is happened, at this point the damage is not happened. It need to predict which machine learning algorithm we can try. There is a pipe, gasoline pipe. If a damage happen means it will be predict using the, there is a sensor also, not everywhere sensor. Using the machine mm-hmm. learning, there is a camera is on, okay, using the machine learning we need to predict.
Okay. So I think decision tree.
No, actually here we need to use a convolution neural network for creating an alert, which exactly which point the error happened. We need to find that, right? Hmm. For that, we will use the recurrent neural network. Okay.
Mm. Okay.
Like if you just try like this, okay, we can use a decision tree also. Mm-hmm. Like we can use the decision tree whether it is broken at this point or this point. You can use a random forest also. If it is a data means you can do that. If it is not a data, if it is a external output means you can try with like neural network. You can try. Okay, is it understandable? Right. You have
yes.
to tokenize to the. Point at this sector, this is gasoline is damaged, this sector, every sector come under the word which will be, we can using the LSTM, we can tokenize that embedding and tokenize it, we will do that and we can try that. Able to understand, right? You will understand.
Yes.
We will view at a point means you can understand. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You can able to understand right now. Some problems.
Yes, ma'am.
Some problem means how can we solve? If car counting means which kind of neural network you will use? For car counting, we will use the CNN. Okay. CNN we will use. CNN is enough. Only one neural network is enough. CNN and the car counting. And type of car counting. If there is a lorry, the truck, there is a lot of things means you need to make a lot of 5 to 10 vehicle, 10 vehicle and different vehicle. You can count, but it will be also reported as a different data. There is a 10 lorry crossed, 5 car is crossed, 5 white car is crossed, 5 Lamborghini. This thing are we can make it as a report also. Able to understand, right? If it is a different.
Yes.
You can try that also.
So it will come under image identification, like how to identify image.
Yeah, it will be so come which under image the convolution neural network we have to use. Convolution neural network, we will use that. Actually, suppose if difference between the video, okay, video and images, video is a lot of frames, okay, images, just one slot. Video means there are a lot of image, lot of frame will be the image. That small thing only, that is not a big deal. This is under this is a difference is only this is a lot of frames that's come under the image. Okay. Able to understand, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I will make one model for video streaming also. Okay. Using Keras. So using Keras means Keras is now working. I will try to make one model, okay. I will implement that, okay. In a video how to stream that. Number plate detection I will make, okay, using Keras. I will try that for an image. For a video, I will make one model, okay. So you can able to understand. For a video, I will make one video, one class, I will take the video, okay.
Okay.
Shall we end up the session now?
Yes, Vivan. So you did not share the document. I mean, last session also.
Okay, I will share the document. Okay, I will have the 3 document. Oh, okay. I will share using from my mail itself. I will share. Okay, my mail will be the Immortal Coders. Name will be the Immortal Coders. There, you can check using that. Okay.
Okay, so you are not using PyExpert.
PyExpert, I will use their PyExpert otherwise. My personal mail is I'm using Immortal Coders because I subscribe to a lot of website using the PyExpert. Now there is a lot of messages there. So
emails,
yeah, that's a, okay. I will share using PyExpert itself.
Okay, or did you check that code like image scaling as I have shared with you? I have shared on your PyExpert email.
ArcaScale. You have uploaded in PyExpert. Hello?
I have shared the code and the image. In last session, I have asked one question.
Okay. You have
like
shared
I was getting code. Error.
Oh, okay. I didn't open the PyExpert actually. There is a lot of mail.
Yes, right.
Okay, I will open that all. I will open that and I will test that code and I will share tomorrow, okay?
Okay, sure.
Okay. I have not noticed that. Actually, I will forget some small things. Okay, I will check that. Okay.
Okay, sure.
Okay. Shall we end up the session now? We able to understand, right?
Yeah.
Now somewhat.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Now you will understand the machine learning and. Day by day, it will be understandable. Okay.
Exactly right.
Day by day, you can understand. You can do a lot of problem. Also, you can solve a lot of problem. And nowadays, I'm just learning the electronics. Electronics also. How can we make the build the processor for building the machine learning? but it is very
yes
like a 32-bit computer will run the machine learning model. So if suppose we build the processor for 32-bit means how can we implement outside the computer? Outside the computer, how can I implement my machine learning model? I just planning to do that. If suppose I can do that outside the computer means that will be awesome. We can make a lot of things like hardware. So I just outside the computer, we are making the processor. It will be predicting the new things. Means that will be awesome. I just planning that also, but I can just building the some Android application also on side by side. Okay, shall we end up the session?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay,
thank you, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Okay, Amit, shall we end up the session?